Yeah, it absolutely is very serious, and this has been developing for years.
The root problem is power, right? Like, it's the way authority is. Authority always has and always will be gentle on itself and hard on other people. Like, that's just the way it is. That's what authority is supposed to be. I'm not sure that we can do without authority today. Now, a monopoly on authority, that's something else. But, you know, authority generally, I'm not sure that we can do without that today. But I can say that authority, as it has manifested itself in the war on drugs, is probably the single worst thing. Like, the war on drugs is far worse than whatever the ramifications are of legalizing whatever the drugs are.
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, because the people who would support the war on drugs seem to believe that they can somehow stamp this stuff out, and
they've had decades. Right, your time is over. Yeah, you had your opportunities to stamp things out, and you didn't do it.
You've lost, and the drugs never had to shoot anybody, right? Like, the drugs aren't really fighting back, if you will. The people who are the victims of the war on drugs really don't fight back either. I'd like to make that clear. What's happening in the streets is a result of people's frustrations built up with this insane police state that is sort of I think it's really exemplified by the war on drugs. The war on drugs, before the war on terror, the war on drugs was really the building blocks of the police state. That's what created the no-knock raids that are so common, with, 40,000 of them happening every year?
More than 40,000. That was like 2012.
That's an old statistic. Yeah, lots of them are happening every single day. There are these no-knock raids that
destroy people's lives. Yeah, raids would be no big deal, and people wouldn't be complaining about raids if it wasn't for the fact that they were, they're on drug dealers who have families and they're blowing kids' faces off and things like that. There's all kinds of stuff happening. If you were talking about, murderers and rapists, people doing raids on their houses, that is incredibly rare, frankly.
Yeah, it's going to be hard for people to feel sorry for a murderer having a raid performed on their house, but usually it's drug dealers. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, or join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Josh is with us, listening in Panama City to WYOO-FM. Hey, Josh.
Hey, how are you?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
All right. I was just calling that comment that was made about everybody's inherently bad unless they're held accountable.
It's about accountability, not that they're inherently bad. But yeah, the people that are unaccountable, the people that are unaccountable tend to act badly. Yeah.
Yeah, I kind of disagree with that, because that's kind of saying that unless people have somebody that are watching them to get them in trouble, that people are always going to make the bad decision. And there's lots of people out there who make the good decision,
I think they do. People do make a good decision. Go ahead. Hold on. Let's talk about one issue at a time. Let's talk about how accountability affects people. Would you want to hire an employee, tell them what to do, and then never hold them accountable in the job?
No, I agree.
That's because you'd be a fool to do that, right?
Yeah, you'd be a fool to do that,
of course. Then we agree.
Yeah, but what I was saying is, as far as that is, just a blanket statement saying that people are not going to do the right thing unless they're held accountable, like in life in general,
They are not going to do the right thing unless they are held accountable in life in general. Yes. You see, life has its own consequences, too, and that's oftentimes what holds people accountable.
I see where you're coming with that. I'm just going to have to disagree with that.
Can you give me a good example of someone who is in an unaccountable position who is generally doing the right thing?
How about a prime example, doesn't involve work or nothing. People find somebody who's lost their wallet on the ground, full of money, full of cards, and instead of taking everything out of it, they take the effort to track the person down to give it back to them because it's the right thing to do. And they weren't held accountable or anything.
That's
Nobody
great.
Would have ever known.
You're absolutely right. There are a lot of people that do that. And, people have done it for me. I've dropped my wallet. I think another good example is people that tip when they're traveling long distances. I think that this is fascinating, right? So we're traveling, my wife and I drive from New Hampshire to Florida every year and then back. She stays down there. We stop off someplace that we're never going to stop off again, that nobody's ever going to remember us, and we leave a 20% tip or whatever for a waitress that we've never met and never will see again. And I think that that also
So I think Josh has busted you, Mark. How about you modify your statement to people in positions of power who have no accountability will do bad things?
Yeah, well, you're still in a position of power as a tipper, and you're in a position of power as the person who found somebody's wallet. I think that, you know, you got to live with yourself and certainly your own form of moral guide. I don't know if I'm busted, but the facts show that power corrupts.
Yes, you're absolutely right about that. Now, I wasn't trying to bust or nothing, but just to make a blanket statement, because people are people. The term, it takes a village. Everybody's different in their own way, and I honestly feel, you know, the like you guys are talking about the war on drugs.
Josh, stand by with your comments for the war on drugs. We'll come back with you here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
Measles is activating on a mass scale, now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron, not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UNVEILINGthem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
Attention, do you owe money to the IRS or have years of unfiled returns? Are you being audited or receiving threatening letters? If the answer is yes, you need help. The IRS can seize your property and assets, impose fines and penalties, garnish your wages, and even go after your bank account. Don't take on the IRS by yourself. Don't let the IRS destroy your life. Take action now. Call our team of experts for a free and confidential initial evaluation. We've helped thousands resolve their tax problems. Let us help you. 800-261-7073. 800-261-7073.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, Mark Edge, at mark@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
Sea anemones are the most disgusting of all tidal creatures. Their thick, tentacle arms are engorged with the collected urine that makes up much of tide pools. Whale urine, fish urine, otter urine, crab urine, all sucked up by the moon and deposited in these natural outhouses. Clownfish share a symbiotic relationship with sea anemones. The clownfish cleans the sea anemone. In exchange, the anemone sprays urine on the face of the clownfish. It's one fetishistic delight. Contrary to popular belief, sea urchins are not in fact animals. Indeed, they are not alive at all. They are simply the clumped together leavings of the ocean's denizens.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live in the live Saturday edition. You can take control of the airwaves here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Talking about the war on drugs being a major factor in why everything blew up in Baltimore in the last week or so. Also, accountability. Mark says that anybody who is unaccountable will do bad things, and I think that Josh just kind of poked a hole in that.
I'm not saying that every time somebody's held unaccountable, that they will always do bad things.
Oh, it made it sound – the way you were saying it before made it sound like that to me, at least.
On the aggregate, behavior, human behavior will tend to slip from a moral standpoint if humans – are held unaccountable, if those humans are held unaccountable.
Or cannot be held to account, right. All right, so let's continue here with your calls in a moment, but also want to let you know about how to get Bitcoin, as well as Litecoin or Dogecoin. You can go to expresscoin.com. They're a licensed money services business, and it's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. I bet you will not find a better rate out there than expresscoin.com, especially 0%. You can get zero fee to transfer your cash into Bitcoin by using coupon code FTL on up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency of choice over at expresscoin.com. Good luck finding that anywhere else. Start off at expresscoin.com whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, and you can, of course, do it from your smartphone via their app or straight through their website, expresscoin.com. And don't forget to use code FTL to get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. That's expresscoin.com. So we go back to Josh in Panama City. Josh, you had some additional comments about the war on drugs, so go ahead with that.
Well, what I was going to talk about the war on drugs, but it's mainly more about, I think, the mindset of that whole thing, and I think why the riot started it. I don't think it's so much about the war on drugs, because it doesn't matter if you made drugs legal or not. The criminals are going to find something else that's illegal to do, because it's just a mindset, a criminal mindset.
I don't know whether I agree. Let me address
that. There are a lot of people. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so criminals have always moved into the area of vices that are illegal. This as much as true. So you'll look at prostitution, running numbers, gambling, drugs, gun running, these kind of things. Now, gun running has a problem because there tends to be a cap in the marketplace. Only so many people want fully automatic illegal firearms. But the rest of them, there's just this big hole where you can throw drugs, prostitution, and gambling in, and it's the public is never satiated. So if you legalize those vices, then you drive down the areas where the criminal element can make money. Sure, criminal element can make money in murder for hire, but that's a lot easier. The FBI is really good at finding people who are looking for somebody to do murder for hire. So I think that it what it does when you legalize the vices, the three specifically that I've said, is you just drive the light and the cockroaches have to scatter and there's nothing else for them to do but get a real job.
Yeah, I'm in complete agreement with the legalization of it, because alcohol is just as bad as any hard drugs and kills more people than any hard drug out there. And, I say the criminal mindset do something illegal. It's all about money. The reason they do it is because that's how they make a lot of money really fast.
Yeah.
Right. Well, the point that I'm making here and the point that
it became illegal.
The point that David Simon is making in the Baltimore Sun and that I'm echoing here is it has to do with the average people, not criminals, not the people who are willing to do violence or whatever, but the people who are so frustrated with this war on drugs because their family, their friends, their coworkers have constantly been arrested for these non-crimes, in my mind. I don't consider possession of any chemical to be an actual crime because there's no victim. And as far as I'm concerned, no victim, no crime. But it hurts people to their core when they're arrested for things that don't have a victim. And when those arrests continue to be perpetrated for decades, you get a situation where people don't trust the police, where people don't want to have anything to do with the police, and where people further hate the police for that. And so when finally, tensions boil over, you end up with violence in the streets and, destruction of property, none of which I support, but I also understand where it comes from. And it does, I think, a lot of it comes from the frustrations with the police, which for the most part exist because of the war on drugs. That's where I'm coming from on that.
That makes sense, but I completely understand that, but I don't think that the average person was the one out there attacking the police. I think the
very few people are attacking the police. Let's be clear. Well, very few people are
burning everything. Yeah, and those are the people that cause problems with this. Is I think that some people just inherently want to like destroy things, and
that's
they
true.
These events as their chance to get out there.
Well, but they're also using the cover. And by the way, thanks, Josh, for the call and the thoughts. They're using the cover of the protests as their excuse to go and destroy. I think Josh is right. There are people who see this as a chance to go out and break some stuff.
Sure.
And, you know, regardless of the war on drugs, there would be people who want to go and break stuff anyway. I get
that.
The
news just said that, you know, there were a lot of people coming out of high school and doing it. It's often the young people that don't have, you know, that lived at mom's house and haven't had the consequences of life. They don't know what it's like to earn a dollar to buy something that somebody then goes out and breaks. They don't have the same consequences in their mind. But let's point out that all kinds of things have been done by all kinds of people to A, stop the just, you know, incredible amount of police shootings in this country, and B, stop the war on drugs. And so far, the, you know, from law enforcement on up to the politicians, nobody wants to hear it. Well, the reason is because there's a lot of money to be made in the war on drugs. From the lowest police officer on up to the highest politicians, they understand that the government gets a great deal of money for this. So they don't want to do away with it. The question that, you know, the people have asked, people have begged, people have petitioned, people have done everything that there is to do, mm-hmm. and now they're attempting to put pressure on in a different way.
Let's talk to Jason. He's in Newport, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hey, Jason.
Hey, guys. Thanks for having me.
Sure, go ahead.
I just wanted to make an important connection between, you know, the riots and the war on drugs, and I believe that's the economic conditions. I don't think anybody's out there particularly saying, you know, we're rioting because we want drugs legalized.
Nope.
I think they're rioting because there are no jobs. There are, you know, there is nothing left to do, you know, other than sell drugs, you know, and I think the term criminal is subjective in the point that you are turning people who otherwise don't have that criminal mindset, who don't wish to, you know, go out and destroy, and you're turning them into, you know, the criminals where they have no other options left but to, you know, continue selling drugs, because once you've got that record, it's, you know, we all know it's very hard to attain a, you know, sustainable job.
Yeah, that's certainly true. If you get a criminal record, it gets more difficult to live life, which means you're more likely to stay in the underground or the black market.
We just had somebody call in with statistics the other night, and I can't verify. I have not verified these statistics, but the claim was that it is in some places it is easier for a white ex-con to get a job than it is for a black non-ex-con to get a job, and that's, you know, that can be a real problem too.
But I don't know if I agree that people are in the streets rioting because they're are few jobs available. I think that, you know, they're rioting because they're pissed about the police, and rightfully so. The police are the ones who are perpetrating this insane war on drugs that's destroying their freedoms and destroying their families. To me, that seems like a real motivator.
Yeah, I think that's true too, you know, but whenever you don't, you know, because we've come to expect that people from power are going to abuse that power. Mm-hmm. I think what the problem is that, like he said, they're not being held accountable, they're not being held to the same standards, and, you know, I think all of it together has created a
there's phase. Definitely different factors, and I think that certainly it's true that someone who doesn't have a job is more likely to participate in a riot, right? Like, somebody who has nothing to lose is more likely to go out there and take risks like that. So I think from that perspective, you're probably right about that, Jason. Thanks for your call and the thoughts tonight here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Because of the war on drugs, policing organizations in this country are significantly larger than they would be if we just, say, enforce crimes against individuals where there's a victim, that sort of thing. There's always going to be mistakes, right? Like policing organizations in countries where drugs are decriminalized, they make mistakes too, but they don't have the same animosity towards the public. And I think that that's a real issue.
855-450-FREE. Share your thoughts with us on Free Talk Live.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose-to-nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort Allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
So on Mother's Day, when the rest of you are doing tulips and daisies, Mark and I are taking his mom out to fire her brand new AR-15 built from her AR-15 rifle kit that he bought her at guns80.com for Mother's Day. And guess what? She actually helped put it together. She built the gun herself. Mark's mom is pretty awesome. So on Mother's Day, we're going to lunch and then we're going to the range, and Mark's mom is going to show us how it's done. Get your mom the perfect Mother's Day gift at guns80.com. Get an AR-15 kit. guns80.com. Go to guns80.com.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. Blockitpocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. Blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit freeross.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit freeross.org. That's freeross.org.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. The insane war on drugs continues in earnest in most places, Baltimore certainly one of them. And there's an article over at the Washington Post that cites David Simon, who's the creator of a TV show called The Wire, which I guess is sort of based in Baltimore. I've never seen the show, but that's my understanding of it.
I don't know. We've read the stories about the show in the past, and they're advocates for ending the war on drugs.
That's right. That is that show where there was like a courtroom scene where they talked about that or something. I totally agree with his perspective that it's the war on drugs that has devolved people's relationships with the police. You know, lots of people have become victim of this war on drugs. Of course, it has not made their lives better. In most cases, it makes people's lives worse when they get convicted of some sort of drug possession, and then they end up getting out of jail, having no home to go to, and no job left. And then what do they do with their lives at that point? Is that going to make their lives better? Absolutely not. So the idea behind the war on drugs is it's going to somehow help people, and there's no evidence that it really does. Maybe there's somebody out there. I'm sure there's somebody out there who feels like they've been helped by being put into a jail cell, but maybe that's because they had somewhere to go afterwards with a supportive network of family members that could give them a place to stay or whatever, someone waiting for a job or waiting with a job for them.
Well, I, having spent a great deal of time in prison, would say that some time in jail was helpful to me. Mm-hmm. It showed consequences for actions. I think that the problem with jail is that ultimately somebody who, at some point or another, a person's kind of done with jail. They've grown they've had the growth that they're going to get in jail. And then any period of time after that growth is going to be an embitterment period.
Yeah.
And in when you become embittered, then you sort of have to unravel that when you get out. I got very lucky. I found a book when I was getting embittered. I found a book that was able to help me with the bitterness. But, I will say that jail cells can be helpful. However, they are a very blunt instrument. They are not a scalpel, much more of a bludgeon, a cudgel.
They don't generally solve people's drug problems either, because you
don't
usually get the drugs in the prison. So you can get drugs, all the drugs you want, usually, as long as you can afford to buy them in the prison. So, and then, of course, everybody I've ever known that's gone to jail for whatever possession or selling, they almost to a T are just counting the days on their probation before they can smoke their next joint.
Yeah, I've seen it over and over again. I think the jail is a very, very poor tool to handle people with addictive problems. So many times I've seen it, and they go right back because they haven't gotten whatever it is that's going to solve that problem for themselves. It just doesn't work. It works for some. It works for very few. But
it's got to come from the inside. It's got to be something you're ready for before you end the madness. Let's go to John. He's in Ocean City, New Jersey, listening to WPG. Hey, John.
Hey, what's happening? Yeah, I want to say there's a gentleman named Rodney Stitch, a retired senior administrator for the FAA, Federal Air Administration, and he claims that he knows for a fact that for the past 50 years, the CIA has been bringing drugs into the United States. And even back in 1970, Time magazine had an article about cadavers, Vietnam veterans who have been murdered in Nam, having their internal organs removed and stuffed with heroin.
Now, oh, yeah, I believe it.
Now, why do you think they're doing it? I mean, I've heard these accusations over and over.
Money.
And we certainly have found certain circumstances where people in the government are smuggling things, but oftentimes it looks like, the one guy who's a small group of people who are trying to make money, it tends not to look like an agency's doing it for funding.
Well, what I wanted to say was that this was confirmed by retired head of the FBI, Ted Gunderson. It was confirmed by Senator John DeCamp, Republican senator from Nebraska, was also a Vietnam veteran, and also by John Coleman, ex-MI6 British intelligence agent. These are all top men, and he claimed that if you don't believe that there is a shadow government working behind the scenes in the West, especially America and Britain, he says you are very naive.
What's the shadow government up to?
Well, the shadow government, if you don't want to call them the Illuminati, then we'll call them Big Brother.
Call them whatever you want.
This thing here is that we'll call them the good old boys club, because nobody likes to use the word Illuminati. But the whole thing is that I've had mixed experience with cops. I've had bad experiences and good experiences.
Me too.
It's been all good, yeah. So like, I'd be lying if I said it's just one way or the other, but it's case by case. And I think it's a mistake to make all cops into villains. Now, 15 cops were injured. In Baltimore, a senior citizen home was burned down and a CVS was burned down. Now, that's outrageous. But at the same time, though, if I was black, I'd be pissed off, too. But the whole thing is that let's not make...
I'm not black, and I'm pretty upset about the war on drugs.
Yeah.
I mean, it's certainly true that they target young blacks more so than anyone else, the police do.
Yeah. But if you want to really go after the real culprits, I think we'd have to start with our government. And all it does is... making that rift even stronger between the cops and the regular people, that just makes Big Brother stronger. Thanks.
Thank you, John, for the call. Good thoughts tonight. Appreciate it. Yeah, he's right about the rift. I mean, the war on drugs has created that rift. period.
Yeah, I would concur with you on that statement.
And the war on prostitution and the war on gambling, but those are a lesser extended wars. The war on drugs is the real big baddie, for
I think
sure.
A really great example is what happened with the Supreme Court this week. The Supreme Court ruled that it is illegal for police officers to hold you on the side of the road while they get their friends with dogs to come so that they can sniff around the car.
To hold you any longer than it would take to write the ticket.
There was a case where a guy named Rodriguez had been pulled over, and sure enough, the police officer's intuition was correct. He had heroin in the car. No, methamphetamines in the car. I'm sorry. Whatever. They're all the same to me. He had methamphetamines in the car, and the police officer's sort of cop radar was correct. And I think that, all you can do is sort of applaud that police officer for doing what he's supposed to do in this game that he's been given to play.
No, I will not applaud a police officer for destroying someone's right to privacy. Not going to do it.
I understand where you're coming from. But the Supreme Court rules that this is a violation of the Fourth Amendment of the Constitution of the United States. So the police officers are given this greater job of they swear an oath to the Constitution.
Many of which they've not read it.
Yeah, they have no idea what it says. And then they're told to enforce the law. Now, the law is the lesser law because the Constitution is the highest law in the land. And then they're very good at enforcing the lesser law and terrible at enforcing the greater law because they get the incentives. They're given the orders that surround enforcing the lesser law.
Enforce the incentive is money. I mean, if you enforce the war on drugs, then you get bigger budgets for the police department. You yourself can confiscate personal amounts of cash. I mean, if you come across $100,000 in a drug dealer's house and you're the only one around, you can make that a $50,000 take.
Turns out that drug dealer only had 50 grand.
Right. So let's go to your calls and thoughts and go to Michael, listening in Myrtle Beach to WRNN in South Carolina. Hey, Michael.
Hi. Nice to meet you guys.
Welcome.
I love your radio show.
Thanks.
It's a great show. I just have a simple question.
Please.
I've lived all over the world. I've lived in countries where drugs are legal. I've lived where they're not legal. I've lived in Singapore and Amsterdam, for example. Mm. They're very opposite. And I see a big difference. But what are the thugs going to do if the drugs are legal? I mean, they're going to find something else to do that's not legal to make money because they're not going to have a way to have a job.
Well, why aren't they going to have a way to have a job?
Well, because they have no education.
Well,
you don't need an education to have a job.
What I mean, can't you do a plumber's job? Can't you go working for a plumber?
There's all kinds of jobs where you don't need any education. Very low skilled jobs. You just need to be able to do what you're told to do, push a broom or whatever.
We read an interesting article where it says that even that low level drug dealers in Chicago, where the gangs are very in control of drug distribution, that they make less than they would if they went to work at McDonald's. Now, I have no clue why they continue to work. Is it brand loyalty? I don't know why they work at these jobs.
I mean, ultimately, you're right. If there's something else that's illegal, the people who are in, gangs will likely go and do business with that thing that is illegal. That is sort of the history of gangs and what they do. But if everything that is illegal that is, peaceful, like drugs and prostitution and, consensual, like gambling, if those things are then legalized, then they're going to have a tough time finding something. What else is there? But I mean, you mentioned guns, Mark, but let's legalize that too. And then what else is left after that? What else could they do? They'd have to then maybe do something legitimate.
Drive a shovel. The fact is that I got out of prison in 1998. I had the only credential I had as far as education went was a high school diploma and a GED. I actually had both. I managed to go.
You're a talk show host.
Yeah, I managed to go from working as a waiter, working at from a fitness in a fitness place doing workouts, then working as a salesperson for a radio station, and now I do a talk show. So I think that it can be done.
Michael, anything else you want to share?
No, I appreciate it very much.
Thanks for the call, man. I appreciate that. Let's continue here. We've got Chad. He's in Bowling Green. Chad, listening to WKCT. Hey there.
Hey, guys. I got a couple of points.
Sure.
The war on drugs is nothing but a money game. It's a multi-billion dollar industry.
Yeah.
For those that are in the war. In the army against drugs.
Right. The government makes a boatload of money, and the gangs make a boatload of money. Stand by. We'll get to your other points here in a moment. More with Chad, and your calls are welcome here. Hour number 2 is on the way. We got plenty of time for you. 855-450-FREE. And since we're talking about the war on drugs, let's talk about a very interesting study about one drug in particular, MDMA. You might know it as ecstasy. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live.
Kid, this facility is like a ship. So how do I keep us on course without micromanaging every detail? Easy, with Grainger. Grainger's online tools help give me the visibility I need. I can shop, order, and manage all our activity. Oversee purchases, control costs, all while you guys get to order what you need when you need it. I run a tight ship, kid. I run it with Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Learn more at Grainger.com/online purchasing. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 2nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.15 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,178 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $235. Antiwar.com reports Saudi warplanes attacked a residential district in the Yemeni capital city of Sana'a yesterday, killing at least 10 civilians and wounding scores of others. The strikes sent civilians fleeing the neighborhood into the surrounding area. The Yemeni state news agency, Sabah, reported 20 civilians dead and 50 wounded in the incident, and also cautioned the toll might rise because they are still recovering people from the rubble. This is the latest in a long line of Saudi airstrikes against residential areas in the country, as well as refugee camps, a policy which has killed several hundred civilians over the course of the war. In addition to the civilians killed directly in the war, the final toll is likely to include a large number of civilians killed because of food and medicine shortages caused by the Saudi naval blockade of Yemen. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports the number of U.S. military servicemen and women who claim to be a victim of sexual assault dropped substantially over the last 2 years, according to a Pentagon study. The Pentagon estimated about 19,000 military personnel were on the receiving end of unwanted sexual contact in 2014, a 27% decline from the 26,000 estimate in 2012. However, the Pentagon said the number of military personnel who reported retaliation as a consequence of reporting a sex crime remained unchanged, possibly indicating fear and other intimidation factors deterring some victims from reporting sex crimes still exist. Of those who reported sexual assaults in 2014, about 78% said the incident occurred during military service, a 16% increase over the same period in 2013. The report also said about 1 in 4 victims made some sort of report to military authorities, a record number. The report said, quote, the estimated 25% reporting rate in fiscal year 2014 2019 is the highest ever recorded for the military services. When service members who experienced sexual assault came forward to make a report, the department can provide victims with support and hold offenders appropriately accountable. The report was sponsored by the Department of Defense and conducted by the RAND Corporation. The report concluded, the report shows that in fiscal year 2014, the estimated prevalence of sexual assault decreased across the department and that the estimated proportion of victims choosing to report the crime has increased to an unprecedented level.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
NPR reports the death of Freddie Gray was a homicide, and Baltimore Chief Prosecutor Marilyn J. Mosby says six Baltimore police officers now face criminal charges that include second-degree murder and involuntary manslaughter. Mosby announced the charges Friday morning, citing her office's thorough and independent investigation and the medical examiner's report on Gray's death. She said warrants were issued Friday for the officer's arrest. The city's recently elected state attorney, Mosby, detailed a range of charges against the officers, with offenses ranging from one count of second-degree murder and four counts of involuntary manslaughter to assault and misconduct in office. The most severe charges were leveled against Officer Caesar R. Goodson Jr., identified as the driver of the van that transported Gray to the police station. The charges against Goodson include second-degree depraved heart murder, which carries a maximum penalty of 30 years in prison. The investigation by the prosecutor's office found that there had been no reason to detain Gray and that his arrest was itself illegal. Mosby said that the knife that police officers found on Gray turned out to be legal. After announcing the charges, she noted her own ties to the police community, including her mother, father, and grandmother, who were police officers. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
An unpopular police officer thinks about committing a racially motivated offense for a little support. A middle-aged man is having the best snacks of his life, and a housefly drops everything to go stand on a watermelon slice. This is The Onion Week in Review. Noting the youth center's ping pong table and array of DVDs and Blu-rays, local youth minister Mark Kindler told reporters this week that his church's new rec room has everything a teen could want. The youth pastor revealed that the basement facility's many teen-friendly amenities include a new Wii U console, an iPod dock for the teens to play any music they like, and some comfortable recliners for those who just want to relax or do their homework after school.
We've really gone out of our way to give the rec room a laid-back atmosphere. It's stocked with snacks, but sometimes at the end of the week, we'll spring for some pizza. Honestly, I wish I had a place like this when I was their age.
In other news, increased violence leads the State Department to issue an advisory for Americans traveling to 1861, and an elderly lobbyist is always droning on about how little legislation used to cost in his day.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are back with more Free Talk Live on this live Saturday edition of the program. Plenty of time for you to dial in toll-free and join us here to talk about whatever's on your mind. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. A lot of people still talking about Baltimore, of course, and the perspective that we shared with you earlier from David Simon over at the Washington Post is that it's the war on drugs. That's a major cause for the strife between the police and the people. And I think he's absolutely dead on accurate on that. You're welcome to share your thoughts with us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. Skype on into the show here at username lrn.fm. Joining you in studio, Ian here.
And Mark.
Let's go back to Chad, listening in Bowling Green to WKCT. Hey, Chad, you're back on Free Talk Live. I think that you had another point you wanted to make, so go for it.
Yeah, I've come up with another one on the war on drugs. It's not just the money. It's also creating a second class of citizen. No rights, no guns.
Mm, right. Lots of drug felons out there who've never harmed another person.
Exactly.
But they can't have a gun to defend themselves or their family.
Yeah, a lot of people, and it's not just felonies, by the way. There are plenty of places where people with certain misdemeanors can't have guns either. Mm. So,
right, and that's another way to control. That's That's another method of control.
Oh, yeah, and don't forget that a lot of them can't vote. So
yeah, that's what I said. Voting and guns. Yeah. You create an entire second class of citizen. you throw that in with the job, the inability to or not the inability, but the difficulty, shall we say.
Yep.
You know, you go to a probation officer's first chance at a second impression, that's a big crock, because that felony follows you for the rest of your life. And it's always with you.
Yeah, it
like
does.
A big mole on your forehead.
Yeah,
now, I'm not saying that can't be overcome.
Yeah, I just want to point out that there's some other things to the other side. So, for instance, the Koch Foundation or the Koch brothers have recently said that they're going to stop looking at certain felonies for when people are hired. Hmm. There's been studies that show that ex-cons are better employees than the regular folks. The regular folks out there have had things a bit easier. Hmm. Many times, ex-cons are grateful for a job.
Right, exactly. They're not spoiled. They're not pampered. They're not. They understand that this is a second chance. This is my chance to actually be and do. Now, as far as this drug addiction is concerned, I've done every drug you can do without sticking a needle in your vein, and I've never been beholden to any of it. I've never not fed my children, not paid my rent, not gone to work, or anything like that because I used a drug.
So you are a responsible drug user.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I don't really understand how personally that you could do that. You could give up everything to chase a buzz or an addiction. It baffles me beyond belief. But until a person makes the choice, makes the decision, you can go to all the therapy, the meetings, the this, that, and the other that you want to, and it's not going to do a bit of good until yep. that choice is made from within.
Absolutely true, Chad. Anything else you want to share tonight?
That's it, brother.
Good
Thank
call.
You. I love
Good
your
thoughts.
Show.
Appreciate it. Toll-free number is right on, 855-450-FREE. Yeah. Let's talk to Tim in Philly. Tim, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, guys. A caller called in a little bit ago, and he was wondering what people would do now if they legalized drugs. You know, what would people do then? And I thought the obvious answer was, well, they would keep selling drugs. Now it's legal and they could make regular jobs out of this. I knew people in Florida that sold drugs and used their profits to move out to Colorado when it became legal out there. And now they're successful business owners and, you know, they're doing quite well for themselves.
That's an excellent point.
They certainly are. They have a skill set, right? Like a knowledge base that is probably beyond what the average person who might want to just step in and say, hey, there's a new industry I could step into and make some money. But if I were the one to step into that industry, I would have no knowledge base compared to my co-host Ian over here, who probably knows a great deal more about the ganj than I do.
Yeah, that's a good point, Tim, although you could point out that there may be fewer of them who would be selling those drugs because, you know, there wouldn't be as much profit in it, given that if it were truly legal, if drugs were truly legalized, then there would be open market competition, which would, of course, drive prices down, meaning that the profits that they would be making would be much slimmer. So some people would get out of it because it wouldn't be as profitable as it used to be. But at the same time, the risk wouldn't be there as well. So, yeah, I think you're right. There would be some of them who would be the entrepreneurial spirit enough to, you know, go legit, if you will. I think that that's absolutely true. And I think that also acknowledges the fact, and I'm glad you called about this, because it acknowledges the fact that most drug dealers aren't violent thugs. I know they're portrayed that way in Hollywood movies, but most of them are just people who are trying to either feed their own drug habit or make a living for themselves and their family. At least the ones I've ever met have been that way.
Yeah, I knew a lot of great people that took care of their family and their friends through the profits that they earned. But, yeah, again, you know, just thank you for taking my call tonight.
Good points. Thanks, Tim. Appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Let's talk to Michael in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Hello, Michael.
Hey, I had a point that I wanted to talk about first, but after listening to all the calls, I mean, you know, what y'all are talking about, I went into jail for 120 days, and when I came out, I went in knowing how to grow pot, and when I came out, I knew how to make meth. So
within the first couple of months, I was taught how to hotwire a car, too.
I mean, you know, the war on drugs, you know, just throwing people in jail, it's a criminal school.
For sure.
I mean, that's what it is. But what I really wanted to talk about was property rights.
All right.
Do your property rights end because you're inebriated?
What do you mean? Can you give me an example of what, a little more detail?
Well, okay. I live 0.3 miles from the city limit. Like, I hate the city. I mean, you know, like the cops, the cops are like half a mile away from me. Every Thursday, they're shooting off their rounds, and it's okay for them to do that. But because one night I want to go in my backyard and shoot off, you know, throw some bricks in the air and shoot them like they're clay pigeons, that's a problem. And, you know, my neighbor wants to come over and mess with me.
How big is your, how big is your lot?
It's an acre.
An acre. And where are you shooting? I mean, so if you're just tossing bricks up in the air, where are the bullets going to be landing?
There's like acres and acres and acres, in the direction that I'm shooting at.
Okay. So it's completely clear out there.
Yeah.
Is it clear or is it forest land? Is it, you know, like the plains?
It's forest.
It's forest.
It's pine trees.
Isn't it possible someone could be walking back there, you know, like a hunter or something like that?
Yes. It is possible.
Yeah, I would say that we're not even talking about property rights in this case. I mean, if you were only shooting on your own property, then that would be one thing, but your bullets could go on someone else's property and could lodge themselves in someone else's body, right?
It's possible.
Yeah, that's not okay.
It's highly unlikely, and even if it
whether it's highly unlikely or not isn't going to be much consolation for the family members of somebody who took a highly unlikely bullet in the head or in the chest or wherever it ends up because they happen to highly unlikely be walking behind your property at that time. I mean, generally, the reason why at shooting ranges they have big berms of sand behind them is to protect people from stray bullets flying into their body. So I would say that this question really has nothing to do with property rights and the fact that you are putting other people's property rights, at least your property rights, and that you are putting other people's property and their persons in jeopardy through this particular desire of yours. So I would say that if the police are being called on you, that there's probably some rationale and some reason for that.
My neighbors know not to call the police because, I mean, my neighbors have the same viewpoint as I do as the police is. The police are not here to help us.
Okay, so they're talking to you and they're asking you to stop. That's a much better way to handle a problem.
Yeah, exactly.
I would say that, you know, whether you're drunk or not, no. Okay, so to answer your original question, if you are inebriated, no, your property rights do not go away, but you're talking about doing something that's pretty dangerous. I would recommend against it. Find an actual shooting range where you can go and do something like that. And thanks for the call tonight, Michael. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE if you want to join us here.
I think that drunkenness in this circumstance sort of exacerbates people from an emotional standpoint. I mean, anybody who makes a sober person making this mistake would probably be forgiven more easily than a drunk person making that same mistake.
855-450-FREE. You take control here on Free Talk Live. More coming up.
How strong is Allegra D?
It's my congestion's out of my way strong. Even in the park, playing with my dogs. Go fetch, Bosley.
Allegra D, a fast, non-drowsy antihistamine plus a powerful decongestant that starts relieving your toughest allergy symptoms in under 1 hour.
Allegra D is breathing free for 24 hours strong, even in the convertible.
Allegra D, strong relief for your allergy symptoms. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Inventory is everything. Product sitting on shelves is money sitting on shelves. Managing our inventory is key. That's why I use KeepStock Solutions from Grainger. KeepStock Solutions help keep just the right amount of inventory on hand. KeepStock Solutions help keep the cost down. KeepStock Solutions keep me a happy camper. What's the key to better inventory management? KeepStock Solutions from Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Visit Grainger.com/KeepStock for more information. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
If you're a liberty and freedom-oriented American, come to the third annual Arizona Freedom Fest at Schott's Ranch Shooting Range May 1st through May 3rd. Fun for the whole family. Lots of stuff for the kids and lots of great guest speakers and events for everyone. Food, music, shopping, and more. Speakers include Sheriff Richard Mack, Derek Grayson, Joel Skousen, and many more. Plenty of camping room at Schott's Ranch. For tickets or more info, go to arizonafreedomfest.com. That's the third annual Arizona Freedom Fest at Schott's Ranch May 1st through May 3rd.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live here on the live Saturday edition of the program. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And Sherry's Berries back on board with Free Talk Live for Mother's Day, which is coming up in just over a week. It's going to be the 10th. That's next Sunday, when Mom will be hopefully getting some Sherry's Berries from you, because what could be a better gift than delicious dipped in white milk and dark chocolatey goodness strawberries? The best strawberries you could possibly imagine. Really, they seem to, I don't know if it's like the top 1% of the top 1%, but they really seem to have the best berries that you could come across over at Sherry's Berries, and you can send them to your loved one with a special discount, over 40% savings, by using code FTL. Now, what you do is you go to berries.com, berries.com, click the microphone in the top right, and type in that code. They're starting at just $19.99, but you can do $10 more to double the size of the order, which I highly recommend, because these strawberries are delicious. They came in yesterday, Mark, when unfortunately you were not here. And
I had mine today, and they were just as good.
Yeah, they're awesome. And I went quickly to distribute them to all of our wonderful co-hosts who have been raving about them ever since.
Yeah, they are fantastic. And after we got them, I actually sent them to my mother for Mother's Day.
Oh, great.
Because, they're some of the best things I've ever put in my mouth. They're delicious. And after having tried them, I've heard talk show hosts talk about them in the past, but it just never motivated me to do it. Tasting them Well, yeah, mom would definitely like these. Let's make sure she gets some for Mother's Day. It's a special treat. And, you know, by no means are they the cheapest sort of candy you can buy, but they're absolutely worth it, especially for a day like Mother's Day.
Well, it's not – I mean, obviously something like this is a special thing because, you know, they're picking the best berries. They're dipping them in delicious chocolate, topping them with chocolate chips, nuts, and decorative swizzle, depending on the type of chocolate. There's different toppings on them. And then, you know, they're getting shipped overnight too, by the way. So, you know, this is a fancy gift and it's a good one. I would say that it would be very hard to disappoint someone with Sherry's Berries.
Yeah, they have some other packages there that include the berries and then other things. They have some really cool other sorts of candied things.
Or even flowers, right?
Yeah, they've got flowered packages right, where you can send the strawberries and some flowers. And that's a really great package too. The cheesecakes, and then there's pretzels where they're dipped in chocolate too.
So give it a shot. I think you will be very happy and mom will love it. So go to berries.com, berries.com. Don't forget to click the microphone and type in code FTL. That's FTL, like Free Talk Live, to get the special deals. And don't forget, you can double the size of the berry order for just $10. Highly recommend that. The more berries, the merrier, as far as I'm concerned. So berries.com, code FTL. Let's go right back into your calls and thoughts here, talking about the war on drugs being a major motivating factor behind why it is the folks in Baltimore are so upset with the police, and people around the United States are angry about the police. The police have done this to themselves by enforcing this war on drugs.
Not so much the low-end police officer who's out there in a car, not to say that
they're enforcing the war on drugs.
Not to say, well, it's either that or not have a job. I mean, you know, you didn't go through all the training to get the job.
You can look the other way.
You can, but not every time.
Not every time. If you're on an order to go and like break up a college party or something like that, and if the boss is watching you, then you would have a tough time looking the other way. But there are some officers who will look the other way.
But let's point out where the problem is. The problem comes from the top down, not as much from the bottom up in this circumstance.
Well, that's where the orders come from, but the problem with following orders comes from the bottom up. You, as a human being, have the ability to choose whether or not to act in a moral manner, and by enforcing the war on drugs, you're not acting, in my opinion, in a moral manner, and so that doesn't abdicate them of their responsibility just because they're following orders. It didn't work in Nuremberg, and it shouldn't work here. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. We've got Pete on the line in Newport, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hey, Pete.
Hi, I've got a couple of points, and one of them is, as far as the police there in Baltimore, they have policies and procedures that they have to follow. The city council there is all black. The mayor is black. Three of the officers that have been charged are black.
Half.
I'm not saying that that they followed the proper policies and procedures, because there have been several cases that have already that the city has actually had to pay out. I think it's like $4 million where the police have acted. They haven't been acting as far as their policies and procedures were supposed to be. And they were found guilty, and they've actually had to pay out like $4 million. And the city has actually had to stroke a check. So, and as far as, you know, with the city council and the mayor, it seems like they have, until this has actually came to fruition, they have not actually tried to correct anything in this city.
So what are you saying? I'm not entirely sure what conclusion I'm supposed to draw from this. Are you saying that racism isn't the problem?
No, it's clearly not. It's clearly not racism, because there are blacks involved in the arrests. This is about power. This is about this insane war on drugs, which is being perpetrated black against black, white against white, white against black against white. Everybody, you know, as long as they're in the position of power over others, that's what the problem is.
Most of the rioters appear to have a problem. Like, you know, it's many of the things that are being said by many of the rioters have to do with whitey, though, right?
I don't know. I haven't been talking to them.
Well, that is true, but I mean, as far as the protesters too, it's like they're fed up with the police, because they seem that the police have actually been brutal, and like I say, that the city has actually had to pay out over $4 million in the last couple of years on cases where they have actually brutalized the public.
Right, but that's not going to change anything, right? Because the officers themselves aren't the ones that are on the hook for that money. That's the taxpayers, and so that's why things aren't changing. Pete, thanks for the call tonight, because no one's really being held accountable. Even when the city pays out $4 million, that doesn't ultimately result in any significant change. Yeah, they would be incentivized by higher insurance premiums to possibly change the situation, but obviously that hasn't been the case thus far because no individuals are really held responsible in these situations. Now, in the case of Freddie Gray, we are seeing some individuals being held to account, and as you pointed out, Mark, that seems to be because of the protests that are going on in the streets. That seems to be because the pressure is really on to go after these guys. Now, point of clarification, just because these six cops have been arrested doesn't mean they'll be convicted. You know, this could all just be for show. It could just be, hey, let's arrest these guys, you know, charge them with something, and then later on we'll let them off the hook, and it won't
be a
big deal.
That's not off the hook. I can tell you that if these police officers are going to jail, they really don't like that. The fact is that a week in jail is going to disincentivize this behavior for police. Police do not have an expectation that when they beat a suspect that's in handcuffs, that they are going to go to jail. They have an expectation that they can do that with impunity. So even
if a week in jail is nothing.
I understand that. Compared to what?
You have the protesters are facing greater bonds and punishment than these officers are.
Absolutely.
$500,000 apparently for the guy that smashed a cop's window compared to these cops who've already bonded out. And I don't know what their numbers were, but it wasn't as much as $500,000.
Bonded out for murder. Incredible.
Yeah. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here tonight. So already they're treating the cops differently. It's Free Talk Live.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates. 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary. Not a solicitation for legal services.
Excuse me, is this where I get a license to start a new business?
I wouldn't be hasty. You have to get a license to go out of business, too, you know.
Oh, well, look, I've invented this little anti-gravity machine, see?
Is that why you're walking 2 inches above the floor?
Oh, yes, it's very comfortable. It saves on shoe leather.
Yeah, well, you have to fill out these forms and report to the Human Services Department of Manpower Orientation and register with the Fair Employment Practice Commission, the Wage and Hour Division of the Employment Standards Administration, the State Sales and Income Tax Division, the Internal Revenue Service,
look,
and the Social Security Administration of the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and of course, OSHA.
OSHA? I thought that was a little town in Wisconsin.
You'll find out. Say, floating around like that could be dangerous. Have you checked with the Consumer Product Safety Commission?
Well, not yet.
Come to think of it, you actually are flying, aren't you? Look, you need to go over to the Federal Aviation Administration and the Transportation...
It's very hard to get anything done these days if you're in business, but free enterprise built this country. Think what could happen if we don't keep it free. A public service of this station and the Center for the Defense of Free Enterprise, Bellevue, Washington.
Besides, we just can't have people floating about unregulated, you know.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Mark.
And Mark, another great gift, I think, might be a bottle of wine for Mom this coming up Mother's Day as well.
Well, there's a really great deal. What you can do is go to chwine.com. That's Cameron Hughes's website. And what Cameron does is he goes to the best vineyards around the world and throughout Napa Valley. He really specializes in that area. And what he does is he goes to the vineyards that are known for producing wines that are 90 points and above. These are the best of the best. They're bottles of wine that go for between $70 and $100 a piece. And what he does is he buys their overage. Every manufacturer has overage, and that's true with manufacturers of wine too. Now, they don't want to ruin their brand and won't let him say who they are, which wine it is, but he rebottles it. And every wine that he sells is 90 points and above. And he takes these $70 to $100 bottles of wine. He sells them for between, well, really, it's they say between 15 and 30. But the fact is I found bottles of wine that are less than that on there. And he sells them to you. And you can use our coupon code, FTL, at his website and get free shipping on top of it as long as you get three bottles. That's how they pack them in the box, and it just fits better that way. So they're willing to do the shipping that way. It's incredible. We've had taste tests here, and I haven't had a bad, you know, like these are high-end bottles of wine, every single one of them. They're all awesome. I don't know how to tell you otherwise. chwine.com. You'll get the best wine, and you'll get it an incredible savings. And they actually have, if you use our coupon code, you can get 20% off of select bottles, too. So it's chwine.com. You click on the microphone. It's in the upper left. You enter our coupon code, FTL, right away. Right when you go to chwine.com, you click on that microphone and enter our coupon code. Then you'll see the deals that we have for us. There are deals for other people, but there are special deals for us, 20% off and free shipping. You're not going to get the free shipping without the coupon code. chwine.com, click on the microphone in the upper left and use coupon code FTL.
It's great wine. I've really enjoyed the wines I've had from chwine.com. Code FTL. All right, so our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts. We got Will. He's in Virginia Beach, listening to WNIS. Hey, Will.
How you doing, sir? I'm Will, calling from Virginia Beach, but
yes,
I'm
sir.
From Santa Fe, New Mexico, proud voter of Gary Johnson.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Anyway, I just wanted to make a comment. I don't really have a... I don't mean to change the subject here, but...
No, it's all right. It's Free Talk Live. You can totally do that.
Cool. My biggest concern on this thing in Baltimore is, and I haven't really heard anybody really discussing it, but the thing that scares me is Al Sharpton doing his speech up there in front of the, you know, city council or wherever he was, and talking about making hints about nationalizing local, county, and state police.
Ooh, that sounds like a terrible idea.
It sounds like an extremely terrible idea. You think they have accountability now? Wait till they you know, are being run from Washington all over the country. And I don't know if you saw this speech, but he was talking about nationalizing police departments.
That's because statists are going to state, and that's what the solutions they have. People that believe in big government are going to have big government solutions, and Al Sharpton is a statist through and through. He's a social Absolutely. Conservative and a fiscal liberal. Frankly, that's the worst kind of politician there can possibly be. He's a pundit, really, but I mean, you know, people that believe that the government needs to control your behavior from a social standpoint and needs to control your behavior from a fiscal standpoint. I mean, at least with liberals, they want to have, you know, you want you to be free from a social standpoint, and conservatives generally want you to be freer from a fiscal standpoint. This guy, worst of the worst.
He is. I mean, he's scary.
He was nice when we met him, though.
What's that?
He was nice when Ian and I met him.
Most politicians are nice to your face.
I'm all down for a nice guy. You know, I've met nice guys before, but, you know, behind the scenes, they're evil, man.
Yeah.
You know, some of them.
I share your concerns, Will. I think it's a terrible idea to nationalize the police. It's bad enough to give them all the money from the federal government, to give them weapons from the federal government, but to put the federal government in control of them even more so than they currently are is only going to make matters worse, and I share your concerns. Thanks for sharing your thoughts tonight. Yeah. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Daniel is in Myrtle Beach listening to WRNN. Hello, Daniel.
How you doing? I just got two quick points, and I'll let you, you know, say something about it. I wouldn't have a problem with them legalizing pot as long as they had a way of testing for it at work to make sure somebody wasn't under the influence, you know, in a safety capacity.
They do have that test. It's extraordinarily expensive right now, but obviously as demand increased, then supply would increase and price would come down.
Well, I wouldn't have a problem with it, yeah.
All right.
And driving, too. I don't think that people should be, you know, getting out on the road operating a two-ton death machine while stoned. It's a bad idea whether or not they...
Oh, you're generally safer as a stoned driver than drunk drivers and maybe even sober drivers.
Well, the other thing, another point I'd like to bring up is you was talking about how cops should kind of look the other way, you know, if... You know, they saw somebody with pot and everything like that.
Yeah.
They take an oath when they take that job, okay? And they swear to enforce the laws. Now, if you want the man that's willing to look the other way on one thing, then you would have to accept the fact that he looked away on something else.
Yeah, I want moral people as police. I want people who are willing to look the other way when it comes to bad laws. I don't want mindless automatons just out there enforcing all this stupid crap that these politicians pass. I mean, look, they swear an oath and all, that's true, but they also have full discretion to enforce what they feel is wrong and right. I mean, they can make those decisions in the moment, and that's part of their job, is to use discretion.
Using some discretion, but you're talking about, you know, just flat out, I mean, that calls into question the ethics of the individual. Okay.
I think it's unethical to put somebody in handcuffs who hasn't hurt anybody else, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I agree with that. Now, there again, you know, it still comes into question on the ethics. You know, if a man's willing to stand there and basically hold his hand up, swear on the Bible that he's going to do something, and lie about it, how can you trust him to do anything else?
Again, I don't know what exactly the oath says when the police take their oath. I imagine they're somewhat different state by state. But part and parcel of being a police officer is using discretion. So I imagine that may actually even be part of their oath, that they're there to, you know, help the community. And to me, you're not helping the community by enforcing bad laws on them. Politicians pass bad laws all the time. Shouldn't we have police officers passing judgment on those laws and only enforcing the ones that really matter?
No, it's not their position. Their job is to enforce it.
Their job is to be a human being, sir, not a mindless automaton, Daniel.
Daniel, this is the argument for rule of law. And the point that I'd like to make on this, and I think it's a really important one, have you ever seen a police officer pull over another police officer for rolling through a stop sign or speeding?
Yeah, I saw one pull one over for speeding.
Yeah, I saw it one time on the news, and it's the only time I've ever seen it, and it's extraordinarily rare.
I saw Well, I understand what you say.
And what I'm saying is, and this is really, really, really important, before you go on, this is really important, is that police officers do have discretion. That's the point that my partner's making here. I tend to agree with you. I think we should change the laws rather than trying to ask Ian's asking people to do is just not enforce
them. Use their brain? Use their mind? Be moral people?
But they are already...
You're having that man put himself in jeopardy and his job,
yep.
Okay? Because he swore to enforce the law.
That's what I want. I want someone now, who's willing to take some risks, some personal risks, to ensure that we can stay as free as possible. These cops, by enforcing laws blindly, are making us less free. That's not what I want.
I understand that. I understand that. But then you got that individual that took that risk that you're just talking about. Now he loses his job. Who's going to feed his family? You're not.
They're not, but it is an indictment against the system entirely, because police officers have discretion to not give other police officers tickets. They don't have discretion to not give college students tickets for having pot or
whatever. They do have that discretion, and some of those officers are out there exercising that discretion
sometimes
tonight, and I thank those officers for having the humanity to do the right thing. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free and share your thoughts with us right here at 855-450-FREE. Whatever you'd like to talk about goes, although a lot of the discussion so far tonight has focused around the war on drugs being a major cause of the upset between average folks and the police, which is one of the reasons why things have bubbled over into violence and destruction in Baltimore, because people have had enough of the insanity of the war on drugs and how the police treat them. Because of that, it has given the police the excuse to run roughshod over top of people's rights, your right to privacy, for instance, being violated all over the place, wholesale, in many big cities like Baltimore, New York City, Philadelphia, with things like stop and frisk. Peaceful people have been arrested, punished, put in jail, forced into treatment programs, all against their will, ruining their lives with criminal charges, felony charges, which of course makes life much more difficult, makes it more difficult to, you know, live a normal life after you've been arrested for these things. And many of these people who are getting arrested are responsible drug users, like the gentleman who called in earlier. He said he's tried every drug that doesn't involve shooting a needle into his arms, and he's always been okay. You know, he's never had an issue with addiction. And I believe there are a lot of people out there like that. I think most people who use drugs are responsible drug users. You don't know who they all are because they're responsible. Like, you probably have people in your family who are drug users, and you may not be aware of it because they don't have a problem. They're not addicted to the drugs. And so therefore, putting them in handcuffs, putting them in a jail cell, and racking up criminal charges on them is not going to help them, because they didn't have a problem in the first place. Now they've got a problem because they've been charged criminally for it.
I've been lucky to be able to travel, you know, sort of have in circles where some very successful people are, you know, doctors, judges, mm-hmm. lawyers. I've been to parties where these people are kind of letting loose and that sort of thing. And I can tell you, I know of judges. I know of high-end attorneys. I can tell you that, you know, met plenty of doctors. Doctors who are premier in their field, who are drug users. Now, this is a problem with prohibition. This isn't a problem with substance abuse for these people.
Let's go to your phone calls and thoughts here. And by the way, I want to encourage you, if you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, you can get behind the show as a Free Talk Live amplifier. Just go to amp.freetalklive.com. And for $5 a month, you can help us get on more radio stations and bring more internet listeners on board, expand our satellite coverage, and expose new people to the ideas of freedom. Plus, you get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, the amp-only podcast, the amp-only forum, and amp-only Facebook group. You can get all the details. Get signed up. amp.freetalklive.com. Amp.freetalklive.com. As we go to Patrick, listening in Arkansas. Patrick, you're on Free Talk Live. Tune to KSMD.
Thank you for taking my call, man.
Sure, go for it.
Well, I'm just kind of wanting to throw out something to think about and also a question. But you was talking about earlier about how, you know, I think cops would kind of just like not necessarily turn their head towards everything, but you know, kind of give people the benefit of the doubt, you know, if something's going on, you know. It's not real bad, like, say if they were using drugs or something, you know. I kind of disagree with that because, I mean, the only problem I see with that is if you start doing that, where do you draw the line?
You draw the line at what's right and wrong. You draw the line at what's violent and nonviolent. You draw the line at what has a victim and what does not. As a police officer, I would like them to be peace officers. I would like them to only enforce laws that are regarding crimes with a victim. So murder, rape, arson, theft, destruction of property, those kind of things. That's where the police should be focusing their time and effort, not busting up a college party or a high school party or somebody for driving while, you know, long-haired or driving while black and happening to have a joint in the ashtray or something like that. I mean, to me, it's a pretty clear line.
Well, I tend to agree with you on that. I think there's more important things sometimes out there going on than, you know, the guy smoking a joint down by the river, you know.
Sure, but it's a lot easier to arrest a pot smoker than it is a murderer, right?
Well, it's hard to find the murderers.
There's a lot more work involved in that. Well, yep. One thing I'm kind of thinking, though, is a lot of people have different viewpoints, and, you know, you start getting all over the country if that were to be that way, you know. Well, what if one person thinks that it's not wrong to be a prostitute, you know? Or
I would also agree it's not wrong to be a prostitute. Again, there's no victim. So no victim, no crime. You're asking where the line should be drawn. That's where I think the line should be drawn.
Well, also, like, you know, if you went a little further and said, well, that guy roughed his girlfriend up a little bit, but he didn't mean it. You know, he was just drinking, good old boys. Well, then what if one night he kills her and... you know, he could have been stopped. I mean,
you're talking about something that has to do with a victim, right?
Right. I really have a problem with your stance on this, Ian. The problem is that I don't believe the police department should have discretion. I think a police officer, when they find the governor speeding, should pull them over and give them a ticket. I think a police officer, when they find another police officer speeding, should pull them over and give them a ticket. I don't think there should be 1 ounce of discretion in their job. Now, I do understand when you read their codes of conduct and the rules that they sign when they become police officers that it says that they have discretion.
So you're asking them to be an automaton, a mindless automaton.
Absolutely. I think
that's
we need
ridiculous.
Fewer laws.
Let's have humans, please.
And better enforcement of them. But
yeah, but you're not going to have that, Mark. Not anytime soon. So until then, how about some discretion, please?
Right. And the discretion you're asking for these men and women to have is the kind of discretion that's going to get them fired. The officers that obey the things that you ask will then be fired and not on the job and not able to do the things you ask.
Not if they're careful about it. We get cops calling all the time saying they use that discretion.
We do.
And they still have their jobs.
We do.
Yeah.
Patrick, anything else you want to share?
The thing I wanted to leave with you guys, though, too, is, I've been pulled over many a times. I mean, I've been speeding. I've been, you know, one time I had my tags expired and I got a huge ticket for that. I hated it. And then,
I always wonder about this. Where's the victim in an expired tag?
There is no victim.
I mean, what's the point? Well, now, I get why you'd want some numbers on the back of a car so that you could see if somebody's, you know, robbing a bank, which car it is or whatever. But, you know, for instance, in Montana, if the car's over 10 years old, you don't have to re-register every year. It's just your tag's just good. Why can't we do that all over?
Because revenue.
The answer is revenue. What we have created is a class of, instead of law enforcement officers or peace officers, is armed revenue agents.
I didn't create it. I don't take responsibility for it.
Well, guys, the one thing I just wanted to leave you with, though, is, all these things that I disagree with, there's so many other people that think that I'm wrong. And, I mean, you know, you'll find so many diverse beliefs out there. But I think the biggest problem is the government is trying to control more of everybody across the board. And the problem with that is you're going to find whole areas and regions that believe totally different than someone else. I'm not talking about race or anything like that. I'm talking about just people.
Yeah, I think that's beautiful. People believing differently is fine by me.
Yeah, I mean, I live in Arkansas, and here, what we might look at as really important, someone in a big city might not even care about.
Yep,
you know,
that's true.
Around here, we care about agriculture, farming, you know, people like that. I think the biggest problem is not necessarily what is happening in another area or here and there. I think each individual state or province or whatever you want to call it should have the right to do what the people want to do.
I totally agree with you there, Patrick, and that's why I support secession. I thank you for the call tonight. Appreciate it. We need to have 50 different states rather than this one federal government, which ultimately is an entirely failed experiment. It has become the world's largest and most oppressive government compared to any other government out there, even the Chinese, you know, much ballyhooed Chinese who aren't doing much of anything besides maybe oppressing Tibet and a few other small countries.
It's pretty nice oppression. I mean, we have one of the highest standard livings in the world. Are you talking about oppressing other people around the world, or are you talking about its own citizens?
Both. Both, Mark. There are the U.S. governments in over what? I don't even know how many dozens of countries they have bases.
If it's the most oppressive government in the world, why don't you leave? I mean, that's what, I do understand.
Mark, this is the country with the most people in jail.
That's not an answer to my question.
To any other
I did have a question
world.
For you. If this is the most oppressive government in the world, and by that I mean, I'm trying to clarify, the most oppressive on you, the citizen, because I can understand how you would, you know, might feel that, you know, people around the world being attacked by remote control airplanes and stuff like that. I get that. But if this is the most oppressive government you believe for a citizen, why the hell do you live here? Well, I would not stay here if I believe that for a second.
Yeah, well, okay, I see where you're coming from there, Mark. And what I have done is I've left where I was born. I left Florida to move to New Hampshire to team up with other liberty-minded people so we can try to make things better here. And what I meant was, in the whole, in the aggregate, yes, we seem to have more freedom, and there are other places where you're more restricted in what you can do on a day-to-day basis. So I'll certainly give you that. But the fact that this government puts more of its own people in a prison cell than any other country around the world, including China, should be an indicator to you that something's seriously wrong here. 855-450-FREE, but I'm not the kind of person who's just going to run away from it. It's Free Talk Live.
How strong is Allegra D?
It's my congestion's out of my way strong. Even in the park, playing with my dogs. Go fetch, Bosley.
Allegra D, a fast, non-drowsy antihistamine plus a powerful decongestant that starts relieving your toughest allergy symptoms in under 1 hour.
Allegra D is breathing free for 24 hours strong, even in the convertible.
Allegra D, strong relief for your allergy symptoms. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
Inventory is everything. Product sitting on shelves is money sitting on shelves. Managing our inventory is key. That's why I use KeepStock Solutions from Grainger. KeepStock Solutions help keep just the right amount of inventory on hand. KeepStock Solutions help keep the cost down. KeepStock Solutions keep me a happy camper. What's the key to better inventory management? KeepStock Solutions from Grainger. Get it? Got it? Good. Visit Grainger.com/KeepStock for more information. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keenan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 2nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.15 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,178 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $235. Antiwar.com reports Saudi warplanes attacked a residential district in the Yemeni capital city of Sana'a yesterday, killing at least 10 civilians and wounding scores of others. The strikes sent civilians fleeing the neighborhood into the surrounding area. The Yemeni state news agency, Sabah, reported 20 civilians dead and 50 wounded in the incident, and also cautioned the toll might rise because they are still recovering people from the rubble. This is the latest in a long line of Saudi airstrikes against residential areas in the country, as well as refugee camps, a policy which has killed several hundred civilians over the course of the war. In addition to the civilians killed directly in the war, the final toll is likely to include a large number of civilians killed because of food and medicine shortages caused by the Saudi naval blockade of Yemen. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports the number of U.S. military servicemen and women who claim to be a victim of sexual assault dropped substantially over the last 2 years, according to a Pentagon study. The Pentagon estimated about 19,000 military personnel were on the receiving end of unwanted sexual contact in 2014, a 27% decline from the 26,000 estimate in 2012. However, the Pentagon said the number of military personnel who reported retaliation as a consequence of reporting a sex crime remained unchanged, possibly indicating fear and other intimidation factors deterring some victims from reporting sex crimes still exist. Of those who reported sexual assaults in 2014, about 78% said the incident occurred during military service, a 16% increase over the same period in 2013. The report also said about 1 in 4 victims made some sort of report to military authorities, a record number. The report said, quote, "The estimated 25% reporting rate in fiscal year 2014 is the highest ever recorded for the military services. When service members who experienced sexual assault came forward to make a report, the department can provide victims with support and hold offenders appropriately accountable." The report was sponsored by the Department of Defense and conducted by the RAND Corporation. The report concluded, "The report shows that in fiscal year 2014, the estimated prevalence of sexual assault decreased across the department and that the estimated proportion of victims choosing to report the crime has increased to an unprecedented level."
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
NPR reports the death of Freddie Gray was a homicide, and Baltimore Chief Prosecutor Marilyn J. Mosby says six Baltimore police officers now face criminal charges that include second-degree murder and involuntary manslaughter. Mosby announced the charges Friday morning, citing her office's thorough and independent investigation and the medical examiner's report on Gray's death. She said warrants were issued Friday for the officer's arrest. The city's recently elected state attorney, Mosby, detailed a range of charges against the officers, with offenses ranging from one count of second-degree murder and four counts of involuntary manslaughter to assault and misconduct in office. The most severe charges were leveled against Officer Caesar R. Goodson Jr., identified as the driver of the van that transported Gray to the police station. The charges against Goodson include second-degree depraved heart murder, which carries a maximum penalty of 30 years in prison. The investigation by the prosecutor's office found that there had been no reason to detain Gray and that his arrest was itself illegal. Mosby said that the knife that police officers found on Gray turned out to be legal. After announcing the charges, she noted her own ties to the police community, including her mother, father, and grandmother, who were police officers. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Tides are caused by the moon. The moon's gravitational pull also sucks up the feces and urine of the ocean floor, dumping it in the intertidal zones. The tide goes out, revealing pus-filled cysts known as tide pools, while the moon itself remains hypocritically pristine. Crabs are one of the many disgusting denizens of intertidal pools. They feed on feces and corpses with their demonic mouths, scuttling hither and thither. They compete relentlessly for the juiciest excrement. Finding a walrus turd is truly nirvana for these abhorrent beasts. After accumulating too much filth to move, crabs bathe themselves in the ocean. Waste floods off the crab's exoskeleton and back into the tide pools as the cycle of shit begins anew.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are back with more Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you to call and join us here on the radio waves. You can dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features waiting for you there. You can create the content on the front page. Submit via our Reddit-based system. Submit content. Maybe it's a YouTube video, a news post, a blog post, something you find online that you think our listeners will appreciate. It doesn't have to be serious. It could be funny stuff, too. Whatever. You submit it there, and other listeners can vote whether they like or dislike it. And then we'll look at it before the show and see if there's anything there that we think we should talk about. Of course, the best way to get your ideas on the air is to call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE or Skype in at username lrn.fm as we go to continuing with your calls. But if you're just tuning in, we've been talking about the Baltimore situation. Why so much tension between people and the police? Seems to me that it's the war on drugs. And that's sort of the gist of where we've been coming from here tonight, and that's led into other discussions about generally the police and where things stand today and how that this can be changed for betterment in the future. There's been some discussion about police discretion. I say it's a good thing they have it. Mark, I'm actually surprised you're disagreeing with me on this. You say that in an ideal world, the police should not have discretion when they don't have bad laws to enforce, meaning that if there were no war on drugs, if there were no war on prostitution, these victimless crime laws, if those weren't on the books, then having no discretion wouldn't be a bother to you in that case?
I think that the whole idea of police officers having discretion is the idea that you can let people get away with something that is wrong.
But it's not necessarily wrong to speed either, and you were saying you wanted them to hand out speeding tickets
wholesale.
I don't
think police officers honestly should be handing out speeding tickets. I think they should be on the side of the road looking for careless drivers.
Okay, then.
But I would point this out.
You should have said what you meant, because you would use speeding tickets as an example. And by the way, a lot of
I used it on examples that police... We all know that police officers roll through stop signs, and the other police officers, when they see them, don't do anything about it.
Right.
That is a point about discretion that I think is a real problem. But I would, you know, when it comes to speeding, we have speed cameras out there. If you really need somebody to go a specific
speed. Actually, we don't. We're in New Hampshire.
Yeah, not in New Hampshire. But
you mean some jurisdictions have
most jurisdictions cameras. Around the United States, there are speed cameras. Speed cameras are a technology that exists today. If you need people to go below a certain speed in a given geographic area, you can make that happen through handing out automatic tickets through speed cameras. And to me, that makes a heck of a lot more sense than putting a vehicle on the side of the road with these bright blue flashing lights that are intended to catch people's attention. That's the point of them. And I can tell you as a firefighter that I have been at stops directing traffic where people are busy looking at the flashing lights and what's going on, and they're not paying attention to the fact that they just rear-ended somebody who's in front of them.
Let's talk to Carrie.
These lights cause accidents. Officers die on the road every year.
She's on in Longview, Texas. Hello, Carrie. Carrie, going once. Carrie in Longview, going twice. I don't know, maybe there's some technical difficulties. We'll put Carrie back on hold, and let's try Corey in Savannah, Georgia, via Skype. Hello, Corey.
Hi. Y'all have been talking about a few different things tonight, including the drug war and what kind of jobs might be created after the drug war ends, which hopefully that can't come soon enough. But, you know, a lot of the jobs that disappeared in these areas did so over time. It wasn't just an overnight thing when the jobs disappeared in these areas and crime sprung up. When you get rid of the drug crimes, you're going to get rid of a significant proportion of all the crimes in an area, which is going to economically affect those areas. You know, if you have a lower crime rate, then you're immediately going to have lower insurance rates. Because the crimes won't be reflected in the reports that the actuaries use, and things like that, and that trickles down throughout the economy. Not to mention the violence that's associated with the drug trade. When was the last time you saw two liquor store owners shooting it out on a street corner?
Never seen that.
Yeah, because it's legal, because they can run a legitimate business. So there's a lot of side effects of this drug war. That cause businesses and jobs to leave areas. And once you get rid of the drug war, people can feel safer in their communities.
Absolutely.
There's also opportunity costs for the drug war. Do you know what percentage of burglary cases are solved by the police around this nation?
I can't imagine it's
very
small. Large percentage.
5%.
12.4.
Oh, there you go. Not bad.
In my courses, I actually ask my students, how would you like to have a 12.4 on a test?
I'd also point out that it's many times, burglaries will get swept into when they arrest a burglar. Most burglars do more than one burglary. And I can tell you, as a guy who was incarcerated with burglars, that many times they're like, I didn't do that burglary. You know, like I did lots of burglaries, but it wasn't that one.
Yeah. And I mean, if you look at the robbery numbers from the FBI's Uniform Crime Reporting website, you can see that robberies, they solved 28.2% of robberies, 40% of forceful rapes, and the largest number of cases they solve are murder and non-negligent manslaughter at 64.8%. Now, just by refocusing policing on violent and property crime, you're going to make an area safer. It's going to be more likely that people will invest in these areas because it's not such a huge risk. You know, you then have the police force focusing on preventing and solving these crimes. And when you have those crimes that are being solved, that makes everything look better.
Yeah. And not to mention drug prohibition, of course, leads to a lot of crime in that people have to commit crimes, usually in a lot of cases, to get the drugs that they want because their prices are so high due to the black market. So if you were to actually legalize those drugs, you'd see just a wholesale decrease in crime, period, simply because people would be able to afford their habits with a simple, you know, minimum wage kind of job. Great points tonight, Corey. Thanks for making them. I do appreciate it. Our toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Bob. He's on the road somewhere near Omaha listening to some unknown radio station. Welcome, Bob. You're on Free Talk Live.
How you doing? I'm listening to you.
Yes.
I'm astounded at the intelligence of some of your callers. I just had to make a couple comments.
All right.
The drunk guy with a shotgun shooting the birds. The police officers were very lenient with him, very open. They didn't take him to jail, and they didn't call his state or local federal fish and wildlife and the federal fish and wildlife.
Just to be clear, he was shooting bricks.
He was shooting bricks, and he said that he was using them like clay pigeons.
And further, he said his neighbor didn't call the police on him, so I don't think the police showed up.
Oh no, he said the police could show up. They're only half a mile down the road.
Okay, but he said his neighbor did not call the police.
Right.
Well, at any rate, drunk, shotgun, shooting, something doesn't mix. Okay.
Yeah, it's a bad idea.
We'll switch back to the young man in Myrtle Beach that sounded like he was about 12 years old, about the cops that if they lost their job, they couldn't get a job because they have a lack of intelligence. I hate to tell the young man, but most major PDs in this country, very exhausting to get through their police academies. And it really is. He's never been there, and I know some people on this radio station damn well haven't been there. All the schooling, there's so much schooling, ongoing schooling. If I had a dollar bill for every hour I spent in school, I would have retired a long time ago. He just has no clue.
I don't know if that's what he said either. I mean, maybe, Mark, do you remember that? I don't remember saying the cop wouldn't be able to get a job because they're too dumb.
Right.
I don't recall that.
They don't have an education, so they wouldn't be able to get a job.
Oh, no. What he was saying, and you missed this one, too. He was saying that he's talking about people who would be displaced by the drug war. So, the folks that currently are drug dealers, that they would have to do some kind of crime that if you legalize drugs, you legalize prostitution, you legalize gambling, that those people would have to find some other crime to do because they have nothing else to do. So he was actually talking about what today are called criminals, not cops.
He made it sound the other way.
Okay.
Bob, anything else you want to share?
Sometimes I can be a little bit. Yeah, there you are right, though. Your other gentleman was saying that there's discretion involved in policing. There is not. Every PD's got an SOP, standard operating procedure, and there's nothing in anybody that says you have discretion.
You're totally wrong about that. Thank you, Bob, for the call tonight. I can pull up the Keene police. We live in Keene, New Hampshire here. I can pull up their statement of whatever the heck it is they have posted on their wall when you walk in. It's on their website. It uses the word discretion. I'll prove it if I need to. And most cops will tell you they've got discretion. In fact, there's one on hold. Maybe we'll ask him.
Are you completely free of stress and fatigue? Well, of course not. You aren't alone, though. Now think about how nice it would be to begin relieving some of that stress and fatigue. Let me introduce you to a product that has and is working for me. It's called Youthful Greens. Youthful Greens. It's packed full of nature's nourishing, cleansing, and alkalizing greens, providing a powerful dose of whole food nutrition in each serving. Youthful Greens helps increase overall energy levels and reduce all that fatigue and stress on your body. And right now, when you visit freegreens.net or call 800-333-6923 and order your one-month supply of Youthful Greens for only $29.95, you get another month's supply for free. That's 2 months of Youthful Greens for the already low price of just $29.95, plus free shipping. That's saving you $45. Visit freegreens.net today or simply call 800-333-6923. And hey, you're welcome.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Do you ever say, "I could care less," when you really mean the opposite? You mean to say, "I couldn't care less." It's a common mistake. You are judged by how you speak, especially if you're looking for work, with so many more applicants than openings now. But even if you're not, avoiding common misstatements will help you make the most of the dozens of conversations and transactions that crowd your daily routine. So whatever you say, don't say "whatever" as a single word sentence. It's the most annoying expression in the American English language, according to a recent poll. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. But seriously, at the end of the day, you'll want to avoid this scenario, sounding like everyone else. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition of the program. You can join us here toll-free. Bring up whatever's on your mind. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online, of course, over at freetalklive.com. But if you're online, then you need to know how to protect yourself. Not just from viruses. That's the obvious thing, right? I'm talking about protect yourself from spying, protecting yourself from nosy people, criminal people who might want to steal your credit card information, your bank account logins, maybe your own internet service provider logging all of the websites you visit, logging the search terms you're entering, and then using that to data mine you, sell the information to somebody else, or hand it over to the government. ProXPN can protect you, can help protect you from a lot of that. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. You can download their free software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS, Android, and Linux. So whichever operating system you're running, there's likely ProXPN for you. ProXPN is a global virtual private network. It encrypts your data connection, which means that there's no more prying and spying on behalf of your ISP or people trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets. You just go and get started for free over at proxpn.com/FTL. And when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account, because you're going to want the unlimited bandwidth, the servers around the world that you can access, which allows you to get past regionally blocked websites. You can also privately torrent with their premium account. You get it at 50% off the price of the annual package by using code FTL50. That's FTL and the number 50 as your discount code over at proxpn.com/FTL. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and you can feel good because ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. So again, promo code FTL50. Get a great discount on privacy that is priceless at proxpn.com/FTL. Let's go to Straight Razor, listening in Dallas. Straight Razor is someone who's called the show in the past. He says he is a police officer. I tend to believe his claims. Straight Razor, welcome back to Free Talk Live.
Good evening, gentlemen. So I find it incredibly frustrating that people seem to believe that it's some kind of arbitrary boundary that that officers set on what they enforce. It's not just random poof, I decide today I'm going to enforce drug laws, and then tomorrow I decide I'm not going to. I believe that everyone has the right to do what they want to do so long as they don't infringe another person's rights. That means if you want to smoke crack cocaine on the corner on your own property, it doesn't matter. Why should I waste your money enforcing a law that affects no one?
I wish more officers had your personal philosophy. Now tell me about discretion, because that last guy called in, he insisted that police officers don't have discretion, and I know he's wrong about that. It's right here in the Statement of Values and Professionalism of the Keene Police Department. They say, quote, "We will obey and enforce the laws of the state of New Hampshire with courage, diligence, and discretion."
Now, many places do not have discretion in their oath. I know that in my state, I did not have discretion in my oath. However, it does say, to the best of my abilities.
Mm.
It also puts things in specific order. If you're ever looking at, you know, looking at laws, generally they'll put them in the order of what is most important. So in mine, the Constitution comes before laws of the state. Now, I know this, you guys aren't big on the, or you in particular are not big on the Constitution. However, I see that as I choose that I'm only going to enforce laws that affect others' rights. And that trumps the state law.
Excellent.
Yeah, I think it does. I mean, when you're talking about a constitution, it's the highest law in the land. The states signed on to the federal constitution, making it higher than the state constitutions. The state constitutions are higher than the federal laws, and in my opinion, and the state laws. And then, you know, that's just sort of how it goes. So absolutely, it seems to me that if you, as a police officer, judge a law to be counter-constitutional, you shouldn't be enforcing it.
Yeah, it's right here as well. The Law Enforcement Code of Ethics for the Keene Police Department says, as a law enforcement officer, my fundamental duty, which would mean the highest level of duty, is to serve mankind, safeguard lives and property, protect the innocent against deception, the weak against oppression or intimidation, the peaceful against violence or disorder, and to respect the constitutional rights of all people to liberty, equality, and justice. So presumably any law that violates that fundamental duty, they should not be enforcing, right?
Exactly. So, and the other thing is that when you're talking about drugs, you know, I do not make drug arrests, because for reasons previously stated. However, the drug arrests I have made have been when someone has broken into another person's home to acquire money
mm-hmm.
to buy drugs.
Now, Mark said earlier, Straight Razor, Mark said that if you don't make drug arrests, you're going to get fired. And I said, well, that would probably only happen in a circumstance where the boss is, like, watching you and you feel like you have to make an arrest. Have you ever been in a situation like that where, you know, like you've been ordered to go bust up a high school party or something like that? What has happened in those circumstances if you've had to face it?
So the thing that has greatly improved my longevity at any job, and I've had many, as I told you guys the other day, is that since I'm not focusing on busting somebody driving around with a joint in their ashtray, I'm focusing on things like domestic disputes where a woman is bleeding from her head, or gruesome things that other officers do not want to deal with. So what happens is they can either give me a hard time about not busting the guy driving around, or they themselves will have to go deal with the gruesome situation and the arguments and everything else that comes along with that.
I see. So you make it easier for the other officers to go bust people for drugs.
Well, in a way, yes. But at the same time, I'm not wasting my time on something that shouldn't be. I'm not wasting my time on those. I'm actually helping the people who are involuntarily paying for my services.
So are you saying that the people in the department already know that you are less likely to enforce drug laws, and that's why they don't send you on those calls?
Well, so you're going to get you almost get like a rap sheet as a police officer on, you know, they can see your names on everything, your badge numbers on everything. So they can look back and see exactly how many speeding tickets you've written, how many drug busts you have, the types of calls that you're going to.
Mm-hmm.
So absolutely, there's no way that someone couldn't look at my record and see that I don't enforce drug laws. There's no way.
But give me another, but a specific example, right? Like it's not uncommon for, it's Saturday night right now as we're doing the show. Right now there are various college and high school parties going on. And in many of many towns, a bunch of officers will show up at these parties and they will arrest, right? They'll kids will go scrambling everywhere. So that's why they bring a bunch of officers to run after them and tackle them and, you know, do all that. And so if, you know, the department is getting ready to, they're gearing up to go bust one of these college parties or whatever, where they know people are going to have underage possession of alcohol. I mean, it's like, you know, shooting fish in a barrel for the cops doing these busts. And they say, do they even turn to you and say, Straight Razor, you're coming with us? I mean, and if so, what would you say? And what would you do?
So if I'm in, now I have had to involuntarily move employment before for something similar to this, but generally I'll say, you know, well, you've got 15 officers, why do you need 16?
Wow, good on you, man.
Or another call.
I
or
think
another
that's,
call will come up.
I think that's the kind of heroism I want to see.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to call it heroic.
Yeah.
Please. I just wouldn't call it, I just wouldn't expect it from any other officer.
There you go. Thanks for the call, Straight Razor. I appreciate it. Thanks for the efforts, and thanks for doing what you do. More coming up here. It's Free Talk Live.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@markatfreetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kid Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kidessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
When there are cameras around, it doesn't make a difference. There were people with video cameras all over this event yesterday.
That's and good. It looked like these people were trying to get away.
Yes,
honestly.
Yes, they were. They were being shot.
These weren't people rushing towards the cop phalanx.
Nope.
That's right.
They were trying to get away.
And those batons weren't rubber like the bullets were.
They were either trying to get away or they were members of the news media trying to cover the event.
Right.
Police are supposed to be there to protect and serve.
Allegedly
to be peace officers. And instead, they're creating war.
And, of course, the chief of police is claiming he'll investigate. What they're going to investigate, I don't know. It's going to be very difficult to identify the officers in this video footage because there were so many of them.
Mm-hmm.
There was an army of police officers out there, and every single one of them was participating in the attack on unarmed, innocent people.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here. Join us on this live Saturday edition, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. A discussion that started about Baltimore and why there's so much tension between the police and average people. The answer was the war on drugs. Has led into a discussion about policing in general, discretion specifically in policing right now. And still to come here, I do have this interesting story about a scientific study that's been done on MDMA, one of the most popular illegal drugs in the world. But first, let's continue with your calls and thoughts. However, Mark, you've got a special deal going on right now.
Yeah, I just want to let people know that there is a special deal going on Free Talk Live ads. We're having a sale right now. Now, really, when it comes to advertising, a lot of people don't know, a lot of business owners don't know that there's different types of advertising. There's pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where your customer's going on the internet and they're looking for whatever it is that you might sell in your area, and your AdWord is there trying to pull the person into your business as opposed to the other guy's business.
Broken dishwasher.
Right. And that's how that goes.
Yeah.
Push advertising is something else. Push advertising says that to a person who, may not even have a broke dishwasher, that you sell dishwashers. And maybe they'll think, I didn't never like the color, or their dishwasher breaks down that evening, or whatever. You're advertising to them. You're pushing a message out, and you're getting it to them before they have a problem, before the other guys add in Google AdWords. And I think that this is... you need to understand that there's different types of advertising, and radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there's
it's branding.
Yeah, it's branding, and we're inundated with ads all over. But talk radio
people tend to have a relationship with the talk show host, so they have a more positive view of the advertising that's going on. So Free Talk Live, we're on 150 stations across the country. We've got certainly a 250,000 people listening in a given week. I can't tell you exactly because, frankly, I don't know exactly. But we are having a sale right now for that. It's basically $10 a 30-second ad. You can get 200 30-second ads for $1,997. And all you have to do is email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
All right. So our toll-free number here tonight, 855-450-FREE. Let's go right back into your calls and thoughts. Christine is on the line listening in Madison to the Mike 92.1. Hey, Christine.
Hi.
You're on the radio. Go ahead.
Oh, I called because you're talking about discretion, and there's a lot of supposing going on, a lot of guessing going on, and it's been going on both on TV and the radio, and I just thought I'd give you some idea of what police training really is. And I not only from my department, but after I became a cop in 75, I used to ride along with whatever city I was visiting. So I rode along in the South, and I rode along actually in England. And it was interesting to compare training, compare methods of operation, at least in the United States. So at least in Madison, we were trained for 6.5 months of just book training. Plus then towards the end, you spent 2 weeks with an experienced officer. You did that 4 times with increasing amounts of responsibility for you. And then after you graduated, you were required to do 40 hours of in-service a year, and you had to go back on the street for a couple weeks a year if you had an inside, say, desk job for a while.
Mm-hmm.
So I got to do all of that because there weren't women patrol officers in those years.
Gotcha.
So they let us work undercover. And in Madison, now you have to have a degree, a four-year degree, to even apply.
Hmm.
And no officer has any discretion about what call he or she is going to. That's decided by dispatch.
Yeah, it would seem so like dispatch would generally.
Right, but you have discretion when you get on the scene.
Yes, you do,
right,
to an extent. Yeah, if a law is being violated, then you're required to take some action, whether it's an arrest or a warning or whatever it is.
Well, a warning would be using your discretion, right? Like, so if you issue a warning rather than a ticket for whatever the issue is, whether it's, you know, speeding or marijuana possession, then that's use of discretion, right?
Right.
Yeah.
And you're encouraged to do it. And I'm telling you, you know, even on traffic stops, if it's not too egregious, you maybe not decide whether you're issuing a ticket until you get up to the car and talk to the driver. And if they're nasty, and then you're going to give them the ticket.
Yeah, everyone knows that.
That's exactly true.
You know,
that's exactly true, and that's human nature. But I wonder about that. If somebody's, what is the point in not giving a ticket to a nice person? I mean, all it really sort of does is incentivize people to be disingenuous, right? They just sort of lie. I mean, I've been given, almost never get a ticket.
Telling who's lying. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I almost never get a ticket.
Talk to the officer and give an explanation for why you were driving like that.
Me?
Yeah.
I usually don't admit to anything.
Because you see, now when the police officer gets to your car, wasn't this way in my day, but he or she already knows what your driving record is.
Yeah.
And depending on that, and depending on, you know, if you endangered someone else's safety or whatever, you're getting a ticket.
Christine, thank you. I really appreciate the thoughts tonight. Thanks for calling in with it and the experience as well. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
What it must have been like to be a female cop back in the 70s.
Well, she said they weren't putting them on the streets.
Yeah, but it must have been very, well, except for what, 20 hours a week?
She said some undercover work.
20 hours a year.
That was about it. Mike, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hey, Mike.
Hi. I just wanted to say that I am the caller before who mentioned that everything is about revenue today, I believe that's the main problem with the police force. The good officers, they're under pressure from city officials, the people that hire them, control them, to turn revenue.
Yep.
And I think whether there's tickets or all of the different things, parking, everything that you talk about in some way or another, they even a court system. You know, they want to get as many people as they can in community service and all of the things that they can do, and it all comes down to revenue, and there's no fairness in it. It's just simply, how can we turn this person into another revenue-producing case?
It's
and
true.
I've had that experience. I own a business, and had a robbery, and I'm trying to condense it, but I was ordered restitution. And part of the money that the people had stolen from me, they bought a car with it. And so I go to the police to get the car as part of the restitution that the court ordered. It has taken me 2 years and attorney fees, and the city has fought me in every – the police have fought me in every way in the world to keep that car, even though they had no legitimate way in the world to even make an argument.
So you're the victim of a robbery. You were ordered restitution. Part of that restitution was they were supposed to hand a car over that they bought with the proceeds of the robbery, and the government won't give you the car.
The police force, the forfeiture division of the Indianapolis Police Department, they fought me, and it's been 2 years, and just now my attorney tells me I'm going to get it, but I still don't have it. But it's been 2 years.
Ridiculous.
The car is set in an impound lot.
How much have you spent on attorney's fees?
Several thousand dollars, and when I went up to the impound lot as part of the negotiation to look at this car, there's hundreds of cars up there sitting that they've taken from people, and that they're going to turn those into at auctions. They're going to turn those into a profit, and most of those people, the reason they didn't get the car back, they didn't have it registered properly or something, and they don't have the money.
They can't afford to get it out of the impound.
It's just legalized theft.
Right, and once it's been in the impound for so long, it racks up fees every single day. It's not even worth it to try to pay to get it out. You're right.
And they count on that. And you can take that, but there's 40 different examples that anyone can look at. I mean, they put people into a community service, and then they collect fees from them every week. And sometimes they put them in jail for something, and they charge them $8.
Excellent story. It really makes you wonder, who is it that they're serving and protecting anyway? It certainly doesn't sound like you. I thank you for the call tonight. It's themselves. They're serving and protecting themselves and their political masters.
How can anyone do anything else?
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
You've been lied to. Being overweight is not about overeating, not exercising, or a lack of self-control. Diets, gyms, and pills can't fix it. It's your hormones. Go to 99skinny.com for a free video where Dr. Steven Siskin explains the four hormonal barriers to weight loss in men and women over 40.
When I first started losing the weight, all my clothes were falling off. I got some skinny jeans, and my husband is chasing me around the table again. I couldn't be happier.
Go to 99skinny.com to see this riveting free video. That's 99skinny.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Hi, I'm Derek J. I don't want a politician to represent me.
To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.fm Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio waves. Even in these remaining moments, maybe we'll have time for you if you call now at 855-450-FREE. If not, you can always call tomorrow because we've got a live Sunday show, and Mark, you and I will be here for it.
Indeed, we will.
7 to 10 at night Eastern Time. Those are our live hours. So whether you're listening live or not, because a lot of our radio affiliates will take our show later on and sort of delay broadcast, as they call it in the business, you can still call in even if you aren't listening live. So just mark your calendar and give us a call anytime about any topic you want to discuss on the radio. Again, our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Our Skype username is lrn.fm as we continue here. By the way, I do want to encourage you to get behind Free Talk Live, and you can support the show by supporting our African satellite fundraiser. Go to africa.lrn.fm. I think it's a good idea to bring the message of liberty beyond the United States borders, and we are actually on satellite across North and Central America, so already there are other countries that are able to receive our signal. But there are some very poor people in Africa who don't even have access to the internet. Well, I think it's very important that they encourage, or that they come across the ideas of freedom, and our satellite signal can do that. I'd like to get back on in Africa, but it's going to cost some money, and you can help us out with that and get some perks too. There's benefits, obviously, by contributing. You can do that over at africa.lrn.fm. Watch a 4-minute long video about why this is an important project over there at africa.lrn.fm. We just got about 2 more weeks left in this African satellite fundraiser. So thank you to everyone who's contributed so far. And if you have already contributed, do me a favor and send out that link to your friends on your social bookmarking sites. That's africa.lrn.fm. As we go to your calls and thoughts, Dave, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hey, Dave.
Yeah, I want to make a strong statement. The war on drugs is a war on people.
Yes.
The state is predators against people. How do I earn the right to tell you what you can put in your body? I hate drugs. I think they're terrible. I would go to great lengths to talk you out of destroying your life with drugs. But the idea that we are somehow a kind and gentle country because we take these people and send them someplace where they're going to be beaten and raped, and we call it treatment, and we feel good about that. I think it's a horror. It is a horror. And believe me, I am coming from completely on the other side of the fence because I used to be the guy that said we need to bomb the countries where the stuff is coming from or it's never going to stop.
Oh, wow.
But the bottom line is I am for liberty. And if you want to smoke marijuana or do crack or do heroin or whatever, you know, I don't think that that somehow entitles police officers or judges or your fellow citizens to send you someplace to be beaten and raped.
Totally
that
agree.
That is not treatment.
Yeah, I totally agree. And beyond that, beyond what you're saying, if you force someone into, even if you don't put them in a jail cell and you force them into a treatment center under the care of a doctor, it's still not good because you're then forcing them into something they're not ready for. They haven't taken that step on their own. And a lot of these forced treatment programs that are sort of the alternative that the state has come up with to putting someone in jail, those aren't helping these addicts either because they're not ready for it. And further, you're usually forcing these guys into a treatment program where some people do exist who have chosen to be in that program. So when you've got a group of addicts, some of whom are ready to quit, others of whom have been forced to go to that treatment program, the people who are forced to be there are not helping the people who want to be there. And so ultimately, no force can really solve this problem. People have to hit rock bottom.
Absolutely,
and they have to
not
be ready for it.
And the drug war, I don't believe the state has any interest at all. Now, there might be in helping people, but now there might be some individuals, and But I think that basically 100% of them, and I mean that statistically, not literally, but I believe 100% of them, they are just interested in keeping the retirements and the benefits and the salaries and all of that stuff going off of our backs.
Dave, you are right on, brother, and thank you for the call tonight, man. I do appreciate hearing from you. They want to keep that money flowing in from the victims of the war on drugs, the people who are arrested for drugs. That's who I consider the victims to be. And also the feds. Federal money flows into these police departments, and that's a significant chunk of their budgets for this drug enforcement, and they don't want that to go away. And, you know, they might actually have to do real work if they have to stop busting pot smokers, have to really investigate actual crimes and go after dangerous criminals. Wouldn't want to have to do that now, would we?
I don't know. I mean, I would really like to talk to police officers about what their thoughts on that are, because I would think that they really do want to do that.
Well, then they should stop enforcing the war on drugs.
So you act like this is just the easiest thing in the world for any
officer. No, it's not easy to do, but some of the, very few things worth doing are easy. Anyway, let's continue here. We've got James. He's in Kalamazoo, Michigan, listening via TuneIn. Hey, James.
Well, hello. I want to talk about a group of officers that I randomly came across while surfing today. They're called the CSPOA, the Constitutional Sheriffs and Peace Officers of America. This is actually a group of officers that actually have taken an oath to not uphold victimless crimes.
Wow.
Yeah, if you go to CSPOA.org, I've got a lot here and I took notes. I know I don't have a lot of time, but it was started by this Sheriff Mack.
Ah.
He was the one that, along with six other officers, actually brought up a lawsuit against the Brady Handgun Violence Protection Act back in the 90s and actually won, well, partially won, got some of the provisions thrown out. But it's just... just listening to him talk, one of the things that he says that officers have an obligation to do is kind of what juries have an obligation to do, too, not only determine if somebody broke the law, but to judge the law itself.
Yeah.
I heard him talking, and he actually says that it's a sheriff's. He actually told the federal government if they came into his county without him being involved, that he would arrest them and throw them in jail. I mean, this guy is pretty brazen.
How is this different from Oath Keepers?
Actually, he's a member of Oath Keepers.
So, I mean,
just another organization, maybe.
Yeah, it sounds very similar in line with Oath Keepers, I guess. Oath Keepers, I don't have both of their mission statements side by side, but here it says on their website, CSPOA.org, that they assemble sheriffs, peace officers, and citizens who understand the grave implications of our eroding constitutional protections, whether it's an illegal checkpoint violating the Fourth Amendment, Second Amendment intrusions affecting your defense of your home or family, or any other infringement of your freedom. CSPOA is on the front line defending your rights and liberty. So it's the first time I've heard of the organization, James. Thanks for bringing it to my attention.
I've never heard of it either.
It's officers that might be listening to the show should check this out. Also check out Oath Keepers. That's another good group. And then further,
there's also a leap.cc, and that's short for Law Enforcement Against Prohibition.
You beat me to it. That was going to be my third example. Good call, James. Thanks for making it tonight. Let's talk to Scott in Greenville, Indiana, listening to WIBC in Indy. Hey, Scott, go ahead.
again, second timer. Yeah, I was just commenting on, you know, largely this situation in Baltimore, for instance. Al Sharpton, if you've heard him say it, he kind of gave away kind of like a lot of what the end game is with radicals like him are really wanting out of this is to federalize the police forces. And if people think they don't like police the way they are right now, being locally and state run, they're really going to dislike it when the feds are in charge and they can harness it to do whatever they want and get their fingers in it. And
no doubt.
That's the way they do everything
else.
Scott,
just a point of clarification. When you said you were a second timer, does that mean this is your second time ever calling the show or your second time tonight?
That's right. Yeah, second time calling tonight. Second time ever.
Okay, because I was going to say we have a one call per night rule.
I would call twice.
Okay, very good. Just making sure, because you weren't the only guy talking about Al Sharpton tonight, so I just wanted to double check. Go ahead with further thoughts.
I don't want to confuse you with that again. Well, the other, he actually said that we need to nationalize the police force and all that, and then I'm going really, and all that, and I'm keep thinking, well, where'd that go? Because Al Sharpton and that, and I kind of look at the president himself, and he does seem to have a pretty strong anti-police bias. Started at the very beginning of his administration when, if you recall, that incident with Skip Gates in Harvard when he entered his house and a concerned neighbor saw him go in there, didn't know who he was, thought maybe he was breaking in and was trying to look out for Skip Gates while he was gone, thought he was doing the right thing. So, you know, the president goes and calls, says the police acted stupidly in that situation. Goes, no, that was really Skip Gates playing the don't you know who I am thing and all that, and then throwing down the race card.
Well,
and
I wouldn't say that Barack Obama has an anti-police bias. Is that what you were suggesting?
I kind of think he does. Yeah.
Well, if that were true, then he would do something to somehow, you know, affect the police, and all he's done is empowered them further.
He is the head of the executive branch, which controls a lot of police.
I would say that, except for the way that they did with Ferguson. With Ferguson, yes, they found that indeed that was a justified shooting. But, you know, afterward, as a thought, they go, well, we found all this and this and this and this, and this is the reason we need to step in and all that.
Yeah, the police are more empowered now than they've ever been in the United States. So I'll disagree with you on that point. Scott, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Every president has supported the police. They've continued to increase the power of the police. I mean, that's
they're
the
head
they
cop for the federal. Right. They're the head federal cop.
Yeah, pretty much. So I wish it were true that he didn't support the cops, but there's no evidence of that. We'll see you tomorrow night. FreeTalkLive.com.
Are you getting squeezed by the economic downturn? Hey, you were doing fine. Then, all of a sudden, you're having a tough time paying your family's credit card bills. Maybe you were downsized or even lost a job, but you still owe 10 grand or more in credit card bills. And you just can't afford the minimum payments anymore. We're here to help. We are the Genesis Debt Partners. We know the secrets to negotiate better terms with your creditors. Make a free 10-minute call right now and learn how we can help you get out of debt. 800-981-7590. If you owe 10 grand or more in credit card debt and you want to learn how you can pay less and get out of debt faster, call right now. 800-981-7590. 800-981-7590. Get out of debt now. 800-981-7590.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keenan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, May 2nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.15 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,178 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $235. Antiwar.com reports Saudi warplanes attacked a residential district in the Yemeni capital city of Sana'a yesterday, killing at least 10 civilians and wounding scores of others. The strikes sent civilians fleeing the neighborhood into the surrounding area. The Yemeni state news agency, Sabah, reported 20 civilians dead and 50 wounded in the incident, and also cautioned the toll might rise because they are still recovering people from the rubble. This is the latest in a long line of Saudi airstrikes against residential areas in the country, as well as refugee camps, a policy which has killed several hundred civilians over the course of the war. In addition to the civilians killed directly in the war, the final toll is likely to include a large number of civilians killed because of food and medicine shortages caused by the Saudi naval blockade of Yemen. ExpressCoin is the best choice for buying Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, and more. ExpressCoin prides themselves on their customer service, so much so that the back end on the website should allow them to be even more focused on your needs. Get your cryptocurrencies with money order, check, wire transfer, or cash deposit. Get started at expresscoin.fppradio.com. That's expresscoin.fppradio.com. UPI reports the number of U.S. military servicemen and women who claim to be a victim of sexual assault dropped substantially over the last 2 years, according to a Pentagon study. The Pentagon estimated about 19,000 military personnel were on the receiving end of unwanted sexual contact in 2014, a 27% decline from the 26,000 estimate in 2012. However, the Pentagon said the number of military personnel who reported retaliation as a consequence of reporting a sex crime remained unchanged, possibly indicating fear and other intimidation factors deterring some victims from reporting sex crimes still exist. Of those who reported sexual assaults in 2014, about 78% said the incident occurred during military service, a 16% increase over the same period in 2013. The report also said about 1 in 4 victims made some sort of report to military authorities, a record number. The report said, quote, "The estimated 25% reporting rate in fiscal year 2014 is the highest ever recorded for the military services. When service members who experienced sexual assault came forward to make a report, the department can provide victims with support and hold offenders appropriately accountable." The report was sponsored by the Department of Defense and conducted by the RAND Corporation. The report concluded, "The report shows that in fiscal year 2014, the estimated prevalence of sexual assault decreased across the department and that the estimated proportion of victims choosing to report the crime has increased to an unprecedented level." For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. NPR reports the death of Freddie Gray was a homicide, and Baltimore Chief Prosecutor Marilyn J. Mosby says six Baltimore police officers now face criminal charges that include second-degree murder and involuntary manslaughter. Mosby announced the charges Friday morning, citing her office's thorough and independent investigation and the medical examiner's report on Gray's death. She said warrants were issued Friday for the officer's arrest. The city's recently elected state attorney, Mosby, detailed a range of charges against the officers, with offenses ranging from one count of second-degree murder and four counts of involuntary manslaughter to assault and misconduct in office. The most severe charges were leveled against Officer Caesar R. Goodson Jr., identified as the driver of the van that transported Gray to the police station. The charges against Goodson include second-degree depraved heart murder, which carries a maximum penalty of 30 years in prison. The investigation by the prosecutor's office found that there had been no reason to detain Gray and that his arrest was itself illegal. Mosby said that the knife that police officers found on Gray turned out to be legal. After announcing the charges, she noted her own ties to the police community, including her mother, father, and grandmother, who were police officers. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A new trend in offices across the country. More and more people are switching to fetal position desks so that they can curl up in a ball on the floor while they work. Aaron Vaughn has a story.
The human body isn't meant